that the position I have taken, according to my religion, which is eclectic pluralism, and that's described in the book. That's the name that I gave to it because that's the only religion I've ever really had. I used to call myself a Christian, but I wasn't qualified to call myself that. I don't think people should put a label on themselves where they are not qualified to have that label. I wasn't doing the things that they say a Christian is supposed to do, and then that, even that became very controversial because I saw people who call themselves Christians doing all sorts of things, and I became, what, confused. Now, one thing that the code is strictly anti, and that's anti-confusion. In other words, whatever you're supposed to be or whatever you're supposed to be doing and all like that, you don't put the incorrect labels on bottles or cans or anything. Whatever is on the label, that's what's supposed to be in the can. So, eclectic pluralism really refers to, it's just, these are terms that I just picked out of the dictionary. And I call it a religion because it's a religion I've always had. I'm a confused person because in the system of white supremacy, with everybody talking at me and everybody is saying that they are right and they're saying that the other person talking is wrong, I get confused, particularly when there's hundreds and thousands of people doing this each and every day. That person is right, the other person is wrong. And every, you know, and so I'm in the mix. And so at a certain point, I don't know what to believe or who to believe. So I have to be what? Patient and observant until I can make up my mind. That's the logical compensatory procedure. You find yourself amidst a whole bunch of confusion. And so therefore, you have to figure things out in confusion, particularly when everybody says, I got it all. I know it all. Those people down the road don't know nothing.
Mm-hmm.
They ain't got no idea what they're talking about. They're being misled. Now, when everybody's saying that around you, it means you have to back off and do some thinking of your own. And that's what I do. That's the formula that I describe what eclecticism is in the textbook for victims of white supremacy that you can get by going to producejustice.com. But that's the position that I take.
Okay.
And so I say I simply don't know when it comes to these different religions, different philosophies, even when it comes to Republicans and Democrats, or communists, or capitalists, or socialists. I say, I'm listening, but everybody's talking at me, as the song says, but I'm not making sense out of a word they're saying. Particularly when they are contradicting each other and sometimes contradicting themselves. And I'm listening very carefully. So I say, what you have here is monumental confusion. So maybe one of these days, when some Messiah appears, the confusion will end. Maybe not till that day. So that comes down to one question. What am I supposed to be doing in the meantime? So I say, well, do the best I can with the mess that I'm in. And that's what codification is basically all about. Do the best that you can in this prison system that's completely weird and completely destructive called the system of white supremacy that we are in.
Okay.
Because that's the strongest religious philosophy that has ever appeared among the people of this planet.